Hey, I'm trying to de-Google and de-Microsoft my life, and in part one of this series linked in the description box, I talked about how I want to move to primarily open source alternatives to the apps that I use, as well as switch to Linux. In this video, I want to talk about the two Linux distros that I'm torn between, the frustration that I had picking a distro, and why I think that frustration is a common theme amongst people who are new to Linux and are wanting to switch, and why I think, outside of just the technical stuff, why people are a little bit hesitant to move over to Linux. I also want to talk about some of the open source alternatives that I've already started using. And to start off, I want to talk about the Linux distro picking frustration that I felt, which also kind of carries over into stuff like browsers. Because for Linux, I saw a lot of people saying that the right distro is the one that works for you, which is great advice when you know what you're looking for. With Linux, it's not that simple, because if I search up what is the best Linux distro for gaming, I get a lot of different options. Whereas with Windows, it's Windows 11. It's the best one because it's the newest one. And with macOS, I think it's the same thing. There's just one option. You can go pro, home, business, education, all that stuff, but there's just one option. With Linux, there's a lot to pick from. But I felt a great sense of decision paralysis, like trying to pick the right movie to watch, because I just didn't want to make the wrong decision. I'd watch a video about how great Bazite is, and then a lot of the comments would talk about how it's awful and you should try a different distro. I'd read a lot of Reddit threads about why Brave is a great browser for privacy, and then a lot of the comments would say, no, it's actually not. It's one of the worst and you should never use it. And like I said earlier, I think this is part of the reason people are a little bit hesitant to move over to not only Linux, but just different alternatives to the software that they use. Windows, Google, Apple, Adobe, whatever it is, like, those are popular, therefore they're good, and I will use those. And if you're like me and you're in this rabbit hole of watching a bunch of videos trying to figure out if it ever gets easier, it doesn't. The perfect distro that everyone agrees on just doesn't exist. But what you will find is that the more you start to look into it, the more you'll hear about the same things over and over again. You'll get a list of what are possibly the best OSs for you. In all my research, it seemed like Bazite, Mint, CashiOS, and Pop were the ones that came up all the time. So I didn't have one perfect distro, but I had a list of them that I could look into further and figure out if any of them speak to me. So it was just overwhelming and stressful, and trying to pick the distro for me was difficult, but I did narrow it down to just two. Initially, I was torn between Bazite and Mint, and when I found out that Bazite was immutable, it made me drop it right away. I don't know how often I'm going to be playing around with my system files, but knowing that I can never do that just doesn't sit well with me. So then I started looking into Mint, which seems to be a pretty popular, well-rounded distro, and it's typically recommended for newcomers like myself. Everyone seems to say it looks outdated, but it looks like Windows 10 to me, so I don't know what they're looking at. But it's great for gaming, it's stable, and it could be my forever distro, so I was pretty much sold on it. But while I was looking into Mint, another competitor entered the arena, CashiOS. It seems to be a relatively new distro that is picking up a lot of steam and a lot of interest, which honestly, I kind of dock a few marks of that, because I don't know if it's just flavor of the month and it's just a regular old distro, or if it's legitimately good and that's why everyone seems to be flocking to it lately. I know it's based on Arch, which is like the hard mode Linux, but CashiOS seems to kind of simplify it a little bit and makes it not as unfriendly for newcomers. And right now, I'm just on the fence as to which one I want, so I'm going to end up just installing both on my laptop separately, playing around with them for like a week or two, and just seeing which one I like more. If I had to pick one right now, I'm kind of leaning towards CashiOS just because of the way that the updates work between the two. CashiOS has rolling updates, which means that they just continuously pump out updates, and whether it's new hardware or new software, you're pretty much always up to date. With Mint, it's the long-term scheduled support release, which I think is just two major updates per year. And from what I understand, some hardware compatibility, as well as just some software updates in general, like NVIDIA drivers or just other apps, you might not get updates for that for months at a time. It's kind of pushing me away from that distro, but I think you can like go in and manually do it, which I don't know if that causes problems, but I think that kind of defeats the whole purpose of the way that Mint is set up for updates. So I don't know. Those are the kind of two major sticking points for me. But then on the flip side, with Cashi's consistent updates, it seems like every single video I watched about people talking about it always mentioned something about updates breaking their system. I'm very much a set it and forget it kind of guy. I hate when I'm turning on my computer to play a game or to do something and then I have to spend my free time or whatever time troubleshooting something instead. Even worse if I have to consistently reinstall my operating system because updates are breaking it. So as happy as I am to have narrowed it down to these distros, I really am on the fence. I don't know which one I prefer. They both have their pros and cons and I'm just not sure. So hopefully through testing it, I'll be able to figure out which one is for me. From there though, I want to talk about the open source alternatives for the apps that I currently use. My goal was to, as much as possible, change everything that I use on Windows to open source, and this is the list that I came up with now. I won't go over everything, but I think I have a pretty nice setup for alternatives. Firstly, I've been using GIMP for a couple of weeks instead of Photoshop, and outside of some keybinds and just some general workflow stuff, it's been pretty easy to switch over. It's been doing the job for my thumbnails, and I don't anticipate there being any long-term issues with it, so I'm very happy to be using GIMP now. Secondly, I started using Kaden Live to edit videos, and I'm just blown away at this software. I remember in like 2006 when I was editing videos in Windows Movie Maker, and I was like, what else is out there? I just need something different because Windows Movie Maker is not doing it for me. So I scoured the internet and there was like nothing. I think I went to Camtasia Studio, which might have been even worse than Windows Movie Maker, to be honest. And I'm just so jealous of anybody getting into video making now, whether it's for YouTube or just as a career, because you have so many fantastic alternatives, whether it's Kaden Live or DaVinci. Like, I'm just blown away by how just perfect and amazing this software is. The two best things for me, though, were that one, the preview. I can actually watch the preview when I'm editing, whereas Vegas just lags around the entire time. And secondly, I just wanted to see the difference in rendering between the two. So I put in a random 16-minute video and rendered it in both Vegas and Kaden. Vegas took almost 40 minutes. Kaden took 4. The exact same render settings. I'm never using Vegas again. It is such a bad software. For Office, I switched over to LibreOffice, which works fine. It seems to be the exact same thing as Office, just not Microsoft. What I realized, though, is that I don't really use Office a whole lot. I'm more so in Google Docs and spreadsheets. So I've been using Proton instead of that, which I'm still kind of undecided on Proton, but so far it seems to be working well. Then for browsers, I had a tough time, which I've already alluded to with the whole Linux thing. I ended up making my new primary browser be Brave because it seems to be the best for someone like myself who's trying to maximize the amount of privacy they have online. I love seeing the amount of stuff it's blocking on my homepage, which just having used it for, I think, a month at this point is just crazy. How many things are being blocked? I also installed Brave on my phone, and I love that I can now go to YouTube on Brave, put on a podcast while I'm cooking or cleaning or out for my walk, lock my phone, and not have ads. It's incredible. Like, on a 15-minute walk, I used to have to take out my phone every like 2 minutes to skip a 37-minute ad. I love it. It's amazing. But I like having multiple browsers just in case something happens. So LibreWolf ended up being my second pick. I haven't installed it yet on my computer here, but I want that because it's not Chromium-based and it's just something different. It scores well on privacy tests as well. And then I wanted to have at least one more, and Firefox was initially my consideration, which I know LibreWolf is a fork of that, but I just don't like how they're so heavily funded by Google, and it also rubs me the wrong way that in their FAQ, they removed the portion about we will never sell your data. That's sketchy, I don't like it, so I'm not gonna use them. Vivaldi was also a consideration, but they're not fully open source. Their UI specifically is closed source, and I just don't like that. I did read their post on their website talking about why Vivaldi is not fully open source, and truthfully, I just disagreed with the entire thing. So for now, my third browser is probably going to be Mulvad, but I'm still kind of undecided on that. But let me know if you have any suggestions, because it doesn't seem like there's a whole lot out there. But that's where I'll end it for now. I wanted to give a quick update as to where I'm at. What's next for me is installing Linux on my laptop and playing around with it. Windows 10 EOL is right around the corner, so I'm hoping I have a decision made before then, because I'd really like to not upgrade this computer to Windows 11, just go straight to Linux if I can. So I feel like I'm in a race against the clock here. If you haven't seen part one, again, that's in the description box. And if you want to check out part three, that will also be linked in the description box. But if it says coming soon, that means I'm living it right now. So make sure to subscribe so you know immediately when that comes out. But this is primarily a gaming channel, so if that's not your thing, just while you're down there, maybe leave a like instead. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all your help. See ya.